What is the best procedure for restoring hair loss caused by male pattern baldness? I'm a 25-year-old African-American male. I've been thinning for approximately 2 years now due to what I believe is male pattern baldness. I understand that it's important to get a diagnosis first, but suggesting that it is MPB causing my hair loss, would the PRP procedure be beneficial at all? From what I understand, PRP will make the thinning hair I already have stronger, but won't prevent hair loss itself. With that said, what is the best way to strengthen my thinning hair and prevent future balding?
Thank you for your question. You're 25 years old, you've submitted several very good photos on the top of your scalp, and you state that you've been losing hair in the past 2 years, and you're aware about PRP maybe having a stimulatory effect to strengthen existing hair, but you want to know what's the best strategy to help your thinning hair and prevent future balding. Well, I can certainly share with you my approach to helping patients like yourself in our practice. A little bit of background: I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. I'm also the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers, a system we developed over the course of the past 7 years using PRP and acellular matrix, as well as other modalities to help people with male and female pattern hair loss. So I can certainly share with you certain conclusions I have come to based on this extensive experience. Essentially, over the course of time, we have learned of the invaluable benefit of hair regeneration, and as you refer to, as this stimulatory effect on hair growth that can be significant with PRP and acellular matrix. And in patients your age, we have certainly had dramatic improvement in outcomes. However, you've certainly focused in on the one significant challenge, is the genetics. Your genetics clearly demonstrates a fairly aggressive rate of progression. To give you some perspective, in the early years of developing this, we looked at people at different stages of hair loss and saw that the overwhelming majority of patients responded to the treatment of just the injection alone. However, with time, we got to see different clinical profile trajectories. Yes, with PRP, with hair regeneration, we can stimulate growth and we can make a big impact. However, when I think of patients, especially younger patients with aggressive progression, there are certain concepts that I think are important to consider and to just have some perspective on. Is it possible that genetically your hair growth cycles are going to be limited? In other words, how many times will your hair grow before it stops growing altogether? Another perspective to this is, what is the relative sensitivity of your hair to dihydrotestosterone, or DHT? For many patients, especially during the early years of the fears about sexual side effects, a lot of our patients were able to use our procedure as an alternative to finasteride successfully for the 3 to 5 years after we did our injections. However, when I look at a younger person, I think well beyond what's going to happen in a 3 to 5 year time frame. I feel particularly challenged if someone's genetics is so aggressive. So a lot of times I do have a discussion with our patients who are younger about a DHT blocker like finasteride, and provide them with information that is in the context of current state of knowledge based on current published data about the drug, finasteride, and whether or not there may be some potential value. Unfortunately, there is no cure for hair loss, and what you are facing is an aggressive pattern that without any intervention will naturally lead to the permanent loss of your hair. When I'm treating younger people, I have certainly seen patients who, even with a DHT blocker, even with hair regeneration, PRP, multiple treatments, will still lose hair. And there are some people that have that aggressive pattern. Others, we will be able to prolong the lifespan, but the effects may ultimately be limited by the genetic programming. Compliance with DHT blockers is also a challenge. A lot of people, a lot of men who take DHT blockers will stop taking these drugs for a variety of reasons. And so you are essentially in that group of younger onset with rapid rate of progression. Essentially, seeking the guidance of a doctor who's going to provide you guidance in terms of management and understanding the limitations of any strategy is still based on genetics and some unknown variables until you actually try the clinical intervention. The art of medicine is ultimately to treat and observe. And with the way I look at it, in a younger person, you want to do everything you can to slow down this rapid progression. And ultimately, you want to get maximal coverage for the maximal time that is your potential based on your genetics. That is the reality as it is currently. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.